What is going on, everybody? We're back in Air Plants, more Madden 23, face of the franchise. Today, we're going to be, or last episode, we, like, fucking had an offensive blow, like, no, it wasn't a blow-up, but it was, like, an offensive fucking, like, show in fucking London with the Saints. So now we're going to advance week to week five. Here we go. What do we got for side activities this week? Open day, dancing machine, Dr. Get, right? Let's do the endorsement, Dr. Get Right Massage Guns endorsement. Attacking cover four. Big Brother. Ooh, let's do that. Eye in the Sky Part 2. Yeah. Fluids Flush. Is it an IV bar? Oh my gosh, okay. Yeah, lock in. I'll simulate. Last message from me for the night, I promise. Had a nice talk with one of the rookies just now. Mentioned the extra time you've been putting in with him on film especially. Just doing my job. Also, mad crochet tutorials. Least I can do, coach. I'm a league vet now, and I know I wouldn't be here without people stepping up for me. Well, it sounds like you've been going above and beyond what we expected from you. If you'd be interested in taking on more leadership responsibilities, let me know. I'll pass it along. Great mentor. So you're hosting your first film review. Do you think you're... Holy fuck, I didn't even read any of that. I can't scroll up and see. Yeah, I'd love any advice you have. I think I'm... that when prepared something, I've selected a bunch of good plays and missteps to review. I'm not talking about which footage to look over. I'm talking about important stuff. If you want these guys to listen up, we need snacks. Fun snacks are a good attention getter. But anything sugary is counterproductive to training. We need to strike the perfect balance between fun and business. What are you thinking? Cheese and meat spread arranged like play art. Fruit and veggies with a good field made of carrots. I'm thinking cheese and meat. To make it fun, I'm gonna arrange it like play art. That'll definitely do. I would have just left it on a tray, but I love the extra presentation. There you go. Alright, so let's head into our week 5 matchup. Another division opponent against the Chicago Bears. The absolute atrocity on the field, Bears. Let's get it.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we've got the Vikings veteran quarterback. He was a tour de force a week ago, 6 passing touchdowns. It's the Vikings and the Bears, next on EA Sports.
Yes, sir.
Spread between 4th and 6th streets in downtown Minneapolis. We welcome you inside spacious U.S. Bank Stadium. Today, we've got a good Week 5 matchup in store here between the Chicago Bears and the Minnesota Vikings.
Here we go, baby. Ooh, ah. Let's start with the ball.
Viking offense making their way out. Here at their signal caller, the fifth-year quarterback.
Counter Y. Running with Dalvin. There you go, Dalvin.
Pretty much unreal, not just in terms of yardage, Charles, but also throwing the 3 touchdowns as well.
When you put the whole package together, I can make you a pretty good guarantee right now. He's going to see a few more people in the box every time he lines up.
Yeah, I don't think that the defense has any choice. They've got to stop him. Can't let a repeat performance like that.
Agreed.
Second down, they go right back to Cook. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Here we go.
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. They'll roll him out right.
Get there.
take this to the other side of midfield. That's it. That's his first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.
Get that. Yes, sir.
Incomplete. This is Albert Wilson. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. So first and 10 now from the 30. Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. The Vikings at 3-1 here through their first four games.
PA post curl shot.
Winners of three of their last four.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
Over pivot.
This early in the game, it's all about making steady progress downfield, hoping to lead to early points. And you can do it with your actual play calls, or sometimes something.
Oh my God.
At the goal line. Picked off by Jalen Johnson. And the Bears are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. It's no secret, he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take
I am
care?
Throwing too many interceptions. Oh, they didn't do anything with it, though.
What happened on the previous drive. He threw that interception.
Hammer dagger.
Relief, though. It didn't lead to anything, just the punt. Now they've got the football back here. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Let's it fly for Thielen.
Go deep. Oh, no pass interference.
Deep ball.
PA boot.
They certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that would be the last shot that they take in this game.
Dagger. Here we go.
They'll look to throw now on first down.
Yeah,
that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
That's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
Cross drag.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Back to throw again.
There you go.
And he's got this to Jefferson.
Jay Jettis.
He's going to have another first down as the tackle is made here at the Bears 35. 23 yards to pick up there.
Hammer dagger.
That's a shot. Interception to throw it in. Come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person
who
plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first.
PAY throwback. I just realized I didn't upgrade my player.
Difficult it is to game plan against
I don't think
because you know you can throw the football.
That's fine.
But how about his
okay.
And he's gonna have to eat this one as down he goes. Robert Quinn.
Robert
is
Quinn.
One he will remember. It's sack number 85 of his great career.
That's
moving
right.
Him past Hall of Famer Howie Long on the all-time list. He'll look to throw.
Yep. Touchdown.
That is caught by
Adam Thielen.
So many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier
Let's
it is
go,
to
baby. And they got
he
a field goal.
His 15th touchdown pass of the year on that last drive, and they'll look to keep it going here, first and 10.
PA dig cross.
Now a play fake here on first down.
There you go.
He's going to find Jefferson.
JJ.
And he'll be taken down. Across midfield. 26 yards.
Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Oh.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They run the counter.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, Dalvin. You're gone. You're gone, Dalvin. So Dalvin.
Boy, Charles, this offense is just so explosive. They lead the league in scoring, and another example of just how good they are right there on that play.
Let's go.
You often overstate about how explosive teams are. This team is truly a threat to score on every snap, especially the first few plays of any series.
And
here
stopped
again
him.
Comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. He's got the lead here in the second quarter. He's throwing the touchdown.
HB stretch.
Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he'll get what he can up the middle. 3 yards. That'll bring up second down.
HB misdirection lead.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up 3 on that carry.
They'll go to the air here on 3rd and 2.
There you go.
And Wilson with it, complete. And they've got it well across midfield. Down here for the toss.
Wilson.
And so Josh Jacobs. So in the Bear territory now, this is 1st and 10, right at the 40.
There you go. Go, Dalvin.
And he's got some space here.
You're gone again.
And all the way down at the 3. 96 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him
get this power out.
Because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Touchdown.
We'll score. Touchdown, Vikings. I think even he's chuckling a little bit now. What a start this is to a regular season. Charles, remember, 3 touchdowns on the ground last week in the opener, and he's got 2 more here. Pretty incredible.
Yeah, he has to be a little bit on the incredulous side, doesn't he? Is this how it's going to go all year long? If I'm dreaming, don't wake me up.
Let's go, baby.
Get the captain of this offense heading back out there. They've got the lead. He's a big reason why. Looking sharp so far. As we
try. HB slip screen.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Setting up
block.
The screen for Cook.
You're there.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
Ooh. Z-spot smash, I guess. That's not what I wanted to do, though.
They'll set up a throw.
There you go.
And a completion to Wilson. And he'll
timeout.
Be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10
Beauty.
Seconds to go before halftime.
Good start. Bloodthirst.
So far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
They'll look to throw here on first down.
Get out of bounds.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside
yards of impressive moments for him thus far. Is that enough for a field goal? I think it is.
There's been no answer for his running ability so far by the defense. I can't wait to see what adjustments they'll have to make during the half.
Come on. Yes, sir. We got the field goal. And we stopped them again.
So here are the Vikings to take over. They're on a three-game winning streak, and right now looking good in this one as well.
PA drag wheel.
They go play action here on first down. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge.
PA post shot.
Took him a little too far at second down. They'll try again from the 20 on second and 10. On play action, they'll
feeling. He's gone.
He's got a man complete. And now off to the races.
Adam Thielen.
They were dynamic in the first half. The halftime break, that didn't slow them down at all. Big strike here in the third quarter.
It's almost as if they were saying, it's not just our skill in the first half is getting this done, it's confidence as well. And confidence has taken over this game in a big way. How about the strikes that we're seeing?
Let's go, we stop it again.
Coming up in prime time here in week five, a couple of division rivalries on the docket beginning tonight.
PAX cross out, or out cross. Bears are fucking too easy.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Buying time to his left.
Dot.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes. That's going to be a first down.
Stretch.
There we go. Their receivers open so far. It's really been impressive.
Go Dalvin.
Design, execution. And he edges
double slants.
Only gets a pair of yards out of it.
There we go.
Down. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They'll look to throw.
Go.
Complete. Jefferson the target.
Oh yeah, Jay Jettas.
A big play there for Minnesota. 48 yards.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
A bench pivot.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw.
Okay.
And he can't find anywhere to
Robert Quinn's hurt.
Down. Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured bear on the field. The medical staff will attend
Flood.
To him, and we will step aside. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Touchdown!
Boom.
Irv Smith Jr.
Irv Smith.
His first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings will add.
Let's go.
On the other sideline right now, it's just absolute dejection. But Charles, let's focus on the positive. The lead that they built here, they've done pretty much everything to perfection in this ball game.
They certainly have. Makes me think that their week of preparation
was excellent.
And they flowed into this game, and it carried over. And right now, I don't expect them to back off at all. They're playing so well.
The only one that hasn't gotten a touchdown is Jay Jettas.
There is the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter. Good second quarter.
Stretch.
Here
we go. Boom. Go Dalvin. Oh my God, look at him.
And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 43.
PAY throwback. Oh, that's the end of the third quarter.
They can't be stopped.
I'm a little bit older than you, as you well know, partner, and you tend to tell
38-6 right now.
And And we return, welcoming you back to Minneapolis.
Counter Y.
And this is a blowout so far.
On God, it is. The Bears are ass. That's why.
A very one-sided affair. They run again on first.
Oh, yeah, Dalvin.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 154 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons.
Oh, my God, you there.
And say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines.
PA post dig.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw.
There you go.
To the right side.
Get in there. There you go. Jay Jettis.
Justin Jefferson. Vikings are about to make it first drive.
Let's go.
Well, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this way. And certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to four touchdown passes in this ball game.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral.
We've hit everyone for a touchdown. Justin Jefferson has one. Thielen has two. Cook has two. Irv Smith has one. Let's go. What a dominant showing again. Let's go. We stop him again.
And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot.
HB zone weak.
Ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. They'll try and wind down some clock with Cook.
There you go, Dalvin.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
HB misdirection lead.
First play of the drive, 14 yards. They run it again with Cook. And he'll manage to pick up about four at second down.
We gotta get him at 200 yards. Inside zone.
And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box.
Oh, yeah, Dalvin. Look at him go. He needs 10 yards. So one more first down, and he has 200. 26 duo. Go.
Cook up the gut. And he'll take this ahead for about
four. Justin Jones. I don't know who that is.
Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured Bear on the field.
Inside zone.
While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. Another tote for the workhorse.
There you go. 200 fucking yards and another touchdown. Never mind.
That one 28 yards on the ground.
And 2 minute warning.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got
HB
a
misdirection lead.
In a game that appears to have already been decided.
What?
They'll
get in there. There you go. Down the Cook.
It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Well, when coaches come into a game,
that's three for Dalvin.
CD, I think this is the type of ball game that they're dreaming of. It was pretty apparent early on that they were clicking in all three phases. It's been fun to watch.
Yeah, sometimes in the NFL, you end up with matchups like we've been watching here. And you go back through the early drives, you can just see that one squad was on a different level in this game. Safe to say, we have been disappointed in watching their execution.
Let's freaking go, baby. Oh, and they got a touchdown.
Vikings head out to take over once again. And they've got to be feeling very comfortable and confident here with this lead in the football here in the fourth quarter.
Jet sweep.
Here we go.
A little jet sweep to start the drive. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. Getting the ball is
Oh my God, Dalvin, go.
And some room to run now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he
reaches the 50. PA Jets lead.
Here's another first and 10. Now it looks like he'll throw here. He'll take a shot for the end zone.
And it's knocked away and incomplete. We beat the Bears 52-13. Let's go.
Everything cooking for them in this contest, the kind of performance that they're going to cherish.
So for the Vikings, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. Meanwhile, for the Bears, they'll fall to 1-4 with a loss. And they will be back home next week for a date with Washington.
I told about making instant music. Advance. I think we can get to 80 overall now. Upgrade player. His skills. Pocket presence. Alright, W, let's advance week. Heading to week 6. Side activities, what do we got? Brand building. The next big step is close at hand with you and your Nike partners. Yes, sir. Just have an open day there, I guess. Leadership. Yeah. Explosive starts. And just another open day. Ever had a plan come together just right? The whole NFL thing worked out. Really crushed 8th grade science fair. The whole NFL thing worked out. True, and it's about to keep working out, my man. Nike has absolutely loved everything you've shown them lately. Assuming you're down for it, our contract there wants to sit and discuss two very important words. No way, signature athlete, Taco Tuesday. You know it, primetime stuff, and you're moments away, man. Now, it's not a 100% sure thing just yet, but you're about as close as it gets. Sending the details your way, and see you soon. Yes, sir, we're being a Nike athlete. Yes, sir. All right, so let's head into our week 6 matchup up against the Miami Dolphins. Here we go. Ooh, we're in Miami too, Hard Rock Stadium.
It's week 6 of the NFL, and we've got the Vikings veteran quarterback coming off a nice week throwing the ball with 4 touchdown throws. It's the Vikings and
Tua
the Dolphins.
Tagovailoa.
On EA Sports.
They have Melvin Gordon? That's funny.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Today, we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here between the Minnesota Vikings and the Miami Dolphins. Brandon Gaughan alongside Charles Davis. CD, you look at the Vikings coming into play. Their offense is a unit that's not afraid to take chances out there, but not always for the better. What do you see them trying to do here?
I think
here we go.
So here's the Viking offense making their way out. And trotting out there, a guy who's established himself as a veteran in this league, now in his fifth year at quarterback.
Double slants. Here we go.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
There you go.
That's complete to Justin Jefferson.
Jay Jettis.
He's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards. Well, there's a pretty big start right there. They go bombs away on the first play from scrimmage.
Put a smile on your face, didn't it? Not because you're rooting for anyone, but
spot wide middle.
That's the way to begin a game, to put someone back on their heels and announce that they plan to be aggressive.
Back to throw now on first down.
Oh, yeah, you're wide open. Touchdown.
And this is taken in at the five.
Adam Thielen completely fucking dusted his man.
Season, and the Vikings go down the field in just two plays to take the early lead. Looking sharp on that first drive. These guys, of course, coming off back-to-back victories, and you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do, and when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won two games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there, that nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
And we stop.
Out is their quarterback with this offense to take over once more. He had the touchdown Dagger. Pass last time they had it. And they'll start here with a first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air.
There you go.
This one brought in by Jefferson.
Jay Jettis.
He'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards. How about this first quarter for them throwing the football?
Jet sweep.
This defense has zero answers for what they've seen so far with the ball in the air. I'm not sure how they're going to change things around, but offensively, I keep attacking.
Oh, yeah.
I keep throwing the football until they make me change.
You're there, bud.
What a move. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. And they get 17 on that one and another first down. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. First carry for
why are you going up the middle?
This is Dalvin Cook. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Okay.
Pretty much unreal, not just in terms of yardage, Charles, but also
PA
throwing the three touchdowns as well.
When you put the whole package together, I can make you a pretty good guarantee right now. He's got to see a few more people in the box every time he lines up.
Ooh, yeah, okay.
The defense has any choice.
Oh, okay, I'm getting sacked by Nick Needham.
Gets him that time as he goes down for a short loss. Trying to get the defense to throw the other direction on the bootleg, but Charles, they were not fooled whatsoever.
I like your description there, because on that flow, all you're trying to do is get them to take
get the feet
step
in.
Or two to the opposite side.
Jay Jettis.
But a really nice job by the defense. They didn't get caught up in it at all, able to bring him down.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up for the first and goal.
Hand off comes to Cook, and he stopped immediately there.
Red zone corner.
That time, and it sets up second and goal.
Hit Jefferson, hit Smith Marset.
Back to throw.
Whoever, you know? I thought he caught that. I thought he caught that off the tip. Dagger. Okay. Pop that, no?
Shot at the end zone.
Shit.
But it's incomplete.
All right, I guess we're taking the field goal.
Excellent today, but not on that snap. I think he was asking just a little too much as he extended that.
Yeah, field goal out, and then they
so
got a touchdown.
The Vikings to take over. They're working on a four-game winning streak, and they lead this one as well right now as they start first and 10.
All right, here we go. HB stretch.
They'll start this
go Dalvin.
On the ground. Room here to run.
Oh, he's gone. He's gone.
There he goes, right side.
Touchdown. 75 touchdown, yards.
Vikings. Dalvin Cook, his eighth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Week after week, Charles, when we see this offense operate, I don't know, they just seem to get more impressive.
They certainly do, and let's face it, it's no surprise they're the best in the NFL in scoring. This team designs things well and executes even better. And here,
let's go, baby.
Few snaps before they're in the end zone. That's how they demoralize teams. That's how they put them on notice.
Out comes his field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game
finishes. Oh, yeah, let's go, Dalvin.
Right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
And that's not a play that you see all that often at the start of a drive, but some teams, they don't mind doing it. And that one, well sold by the offensive lineman. They showed the pass, and then they got out into space, able to get some good blocks downfield and allow the play to be successful.
And time finally runs out.
He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Able to record his fifth sack of the season.
Counter why?
Nine sack seasons in Miami have firmly established Emmanuel Ogba as the face of the Finns pass rush.
On second down, Cook.
Oh, yeah.
Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
Dalvin, PA cross country.
Leader coming into this ball game. Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. On the run, he'll let this go deep.
Oh, good pick. That was actually
Xavier Howard.
Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line.
That was good on him.
They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
All right, it's fine.
Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision.
And we stop him.
Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. He's been in a pretty good groove. They actually have more yards on the ground than through the air, but both have been good, pretty balanced.
Stretch.
A give left side to Cook.
Oh, yeah.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9.
Oh, Amir Smith-Marset is hurt.
Now whistles and a timeout. Looks like we got a Viking slow to get up. We'll get an update.
PA post dig.
Back to Hard Rock Stadium. The previous run good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Back to throw here.
Yep.
And he's got this to Jefferson.
Jay Jettis.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A first down there on a pickup of 25. And he's over 100 yards now after that last catch. Already, of course, leading the NFL in receiving yardage.
So he's done nothing at all to hurt his cause to stay in that spot. But I've been
oh my God, Dalvin. Again, touchdown.
Into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Dalvin Cook, his 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Vikings are able to strike for 6. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. And if that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. They've sort of epitomized balance. I mean, he's thrown the ball pretty well. They've run the ball well. Got to be pretty happy over on that sideline.
Takes a lot of pressure off, doesn't it?
Cross drag.
As much as those guys back there wanting to throw the ball around and be the focal point, When you're able to run it well and hold the defense back from their pass rush,
okay. I tried to throw it away, but I couldn't. Manuel Ogba. Stretch.
Two sacks for him here in this first half. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. And strong running there gets this up over the 15-yard line. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Inside zone.
The Dolphins bring in an extra defensive back on third down. Third down, here's a run by Cook.
Okay, we're punting it.
23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
And they got a touchdown.
Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. He's got to be feeling pretty good. Playing well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the end zone.
Slip screen.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Now they go screen. It's complete.
Oh, yeah.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts.
Let's go.
As the clock will stop.
Drive flood.
Seconds to go in the first half. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
Get out.
Down the field to Smith. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 24 yards to gain there. Another first down as well.
Double
spot. That's a
pretty
throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength. Very nice route.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
And we got the field goal. And they started with the ball after half, and they didn't do anything with it.
Week 5, and we've got another pair of good ones coming up here in week 6.
Wide receiver option.
On first down, he'll drop to throw.
Throw it away.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Well, they certainly knew their challenge as the series began, and they got a stop on play number one.
Here we go.
Goal now, get two more stops and limit the damage to a field goal.
Up the middle, it's Cook. Gets around him.
Touchdown, Dalvin.
Score. Touchdown, Vikings. Dalvin Cook, 22 yards. And the Vikings take the forced turnover.
He's bullying everyone today.
Converted into 6 points.
And that's a drive that makes everyone happy on that bench because they accomplished exactly what they set out to do.
You the Harlem Shake.
Take care of the football, eat up a little clock, end up in the end zone. Now they've got a cushion for the rest of the game. So they didn't just help themselves
offensively.
Two? They helped their defense out as well.
It's Lance.
They'll try and throw for it.
Got it.
And he's got it. So the try for two successful, and that bumps their lead up even further. So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
Oh, and they got a field goal.
This offense back out and set to go for their next drive. The football changes
hammer daggers
here, and as this offense takes a field, Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive. Last time out, they found the end zone for 6.
And they're certainly hoping for more of the same, but the game plan, I doubt it'll just be a carbon copy of the
Jay Jettis.
This offense is ready to break out some new wrinkles and try some new things that might be hidden in their playbook.
Stretch.
They want to use that confidence to its advantage, while also keeping the defense from anticipating what's up next.
A 10th carry in the game for Cook.
Oh my God.
They find some open field here.
Oh my God, he's gone again.
Touchdown, Vikings. Dalvin Cook, 55 yards.
That's what, five touchdowns today?
I know I should keep the focus and the spotlight on the hero.
I'm pretty sure he's gotten all the touchdowns today.
Been an issue for this defense all game long. I can't set that aside. We just saw it again here.
See what he did?
Leads to his long touchdown run.
Okay. And they got a touchdown.
And out now come the Vikings. Well, the win for them at this point seems pretty assured. I mean, still a decent amount of time left here in the
jet sweep.
They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And a 6-yard gain gets them right around a 43. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there.
Counter wide.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright. See the
oh my God, he's gone again.
Right down Broadway. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Dalvin Cook, 43 yards. And the Vikings add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory.
Bottom line, when you play a runner with these talents, you've got to be able to wrap up and get him on the ground. Or the first person who gets there, hold him up long enough for the next wave to get there and get him.
Bro, how many touchdowns does this guy have? He's literally dominating. I don't have to do anything. Dalvin Cook season, like... And they got another touchdown.
Minnesota's offense takes over possession. Well, they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard. But they've scored on three consecutive possessions, three consecutive drives. And I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to pour it on.
Oh, my God, he's gone again.
Because in the old days, people would
have he has five touchdowns, and he almost has 300 yards. Double slants.
Do as they come out for this one. But the way this game has gone, they've got to be awfully happy with their execution overall.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
Oh.
And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down Blood. And incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll look to throw.
Touchdown.
And he's got it. Touchdown. Irv Smith Jr., an 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Vikings are looking to run it to 5-1 on the season as they add to their fourth quarter lead. Well, it seemed like they were so focused elsewhere, they forgot about the tight end spot, and he's the one that burns them there to make this a three-score game here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
I think there might be a little bit of defensive fatigue from those guys on that side of the ball, partner, because they've been spending their time trying to stop them from all angles. This time the tight end gets him.
Let's go. And they got another touchdown.
Now out comes Minnesota. It's been a dominant performance to this point, Charles, and this is probably exactly how.
It'd be misdirection lead.
The carry, it's Cook. Oh, good move.
Oh my God, he has another one. That's
and
six.
Will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Dalvin Cook, 46 yards. And the Vikings are able to strike for six. Well, it has been the passing game that's really been responsible for.
I think he might already be at 1,000 yards too on the year, or close to it. Maybe like 900 and something.
I think, Brandon, the fact that they've thrown the ball so well contributed to that touchdown, because that was a defense that was really key to cover those receivers. All they wanted to do was blanket them. They didn't have enough men in the box to stop the run, and you saw the end result.
That was nuts. Let me stop them.
Now heading on to the field. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football.
Inside zone lead.
They'll try the middle with Cook. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down. On second down, it's Cook again.
Morning.
And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. We are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair.
Jet sweep.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. And they'll go jet sweep to try to pick it up. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to convert, albeit not by much, on third and
26
yard.
Duo.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Zango.
This is Cook. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12.
Inside zone.
Patrick Unlossor up to make the tackle. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Again, it's Cook. This carry brought to an end at the 8. Good stick skills, but not much room to operate. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll run it. Here's Cook.
And another touchdown.
And they are going to score again. Yet
on 7
touchdowns.
They
just added their totals. Well, they were looking to pick up the first down on third and short. They got a little more than they bargained for, finding the end zone as well.
Bro,
and
7 fucking touchdowns.
Near the line of scrimmage partner, so
holy
can pass
fuck.
First wave. There's usually room to roam, and he found it.
7 touchdowns for Dalvin Cook. Holy crap.
Now
and we
Vikings
stop him again.
Gets set to take
just take
it. Here. Beat the Dolphins. And really, it looked at times like they just had this one in cruise control out there.
Yeah, they deserve a ton of credit because
70-38. Oh my god. Dalvin Cook carried the entire day. 7 touchdowns.
And here's the best part for him. It'd be easy to get to the airport because the crowd left pretty early in this one, didn't it?
Well, plus they have a police escort.
Okay, you had to spoil that part of it. Of course, they're gonna get there. But think about how wide open things are now because
look at how much passing yards they had. They had 500 passing yards. And they still lost.
Yeah, they took the drama out of this one pretty early on. So for Minnesota, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week.
We have a bye week.
They get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, the loss here will move them back to 500.
3-3. How much time do we have? We can sim through the bye week. I just want to see the off day. Alright. Upgrade player. Throw on the run. There we go. We're 80 overall. Advanced week to week 7. We have time? I mean, like, sort of, I guess. Okay, ratings adjustment just starting out.
Alright, you're getting somewhere. A big game or two here could get some people talking. I'll let you later.
Oh, okay, that's it. Cool. Big reveal. Oh.
You inside yet?
Oh. I just walked in.
Whoa.
This place, bro, it's legit.
No.
You earned it, my man.
We just got a fucking house.
A lot for you to take in.
Yeah, but I can already tell you picked me a winner here, bro.
Hey, it's what I do. Gotta make sure my guy's properly taken care of.
What the fuck? Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new, and until the next video, I'll see you guys. Peace.